What's up, guys? Charlie here. So, my PS4 just crashed. Sorry about that. It's been having some issues ever since. I guess the beta came out. The issue started on Evo, but, whatever. So, as I was saying, normally I try and do this stuff with Greg, but this time around I'm gonna have to do it by myself. And the goal for Exploring Destiny is to be a weekly live show that you can then catch the highlights of, both on Twitch if you're watching it live, and then on the YouTube channel as sliced up segments, as well as the full thing, because I think some people like watching that. So, my Titan. Titan will be the class I'll be playing in the actual game when it comes out. It's the one I enjoy playing the most. Greg will be playing as Hunter, and we hope you guys enjoy. So as a little treat, they're doing a special event today, and it's opening up the moon. And that's where we're headed. Let's see what the moon's got for us. Let's hope my PS4 doesn't crash this time either. That'd be real nice. Seem to be going. Cool.
We gave up the moon to keep the Hive away from Earth. We hope that would be enough for them.
Okay. That's fair, I guess. That's the moon.
I used to look up here at night and wonder what the Hive were doing. But the only activity I could ever pick up was hazy, like it was blocked or buried. Guardian came here, searching for a way into the Hive Fortress. But he just disappeared. Let's pick up his trail. His last known coordinates are up ahead.
Alright, so I can't summon here. That's good to know. Alright, so this is actually going to be the last piece of in-game content recorded before the final game comes out. I was living in kind of paranoid fear of accidentally burning myself out on Destiny.
He captured this old accelerator from an unknown fallen house.
Before the final game came out, sorry, whenever the game talks, I'm gonna stop talking, sorry if it sounds weird in the final product, and as you're watching this. So like I was saying, this will indeed be the last piece of recorded Destiny footage. I may play a little bit more of it, but my goal ultimately is...
Some of this equipment shows recent activity. Had to be the Guardian's ghost.
So I keep interrupting myself by playing. So the goal is to basically wean myself off the game a little bit. I've been playing an awful lot of it lately, and I'm trying, as I mentioned in the hour one for the Destiny beta, I didn't have the full, oh my god, this game is amazing moment after I played the beta. Don't get me wrong, I had nothing but fun playing it, but it didn't have the same, this is amazing moment I had with the alpha, and I want that feeling back again, if that makes any sense.
Alright, he was looking for the remains of an old colony base. Not too far. Maybe he's still there.
Okay. That's not good.
Fallen. We're being hunted.
Let's get to the ass kicking. Alright. Oh, post rifle, you're so good. So while I clean up these grunts here, the final Exploring Destiny experience is going to be kind of threefold. We're going to have three things. Exploring Destiny, which is going to be gameplay of us doing stuff. Explaining Destiny, which will be if we learn to do something cool or something we find is confusing and worth explaining. Finally, they'll also be talking about Destiny. Or discussing Destiny. I'm not quite sure on the name yet. As I said, as I made a joke in the Exploring Destiny beta video, we're still figuring some stuff out like sound. I knew I wanted to do this via Twitch when I first had the idea for it, but wasn't totally sure how that would work. I only have an Elgato game capture device, I don't own two of them, and I wanted to make sure we get Greg's voice into the cast as well. And I'm not gonna lie, the Elgato is a great system. It's got some limitations in its program, which I'm not a big fan of. They seem to be moot points now. Ah, crap. Did I get anything useful with that? So that was a waste. Nope, no heavy weapon ammo. But I do have a sniper rifle. That's shield down! And I'll take it. These guys are green. That's new. So, like I was saying, exploring Destiny is going to be broken down into three things. The majority of it will be gameplay like this, and me and Greg talking, and as the name implies, just kind of generally exploring Destiny. Does make sense. We have high hopes for this game. We think there's going to be a lot of cool stuff going on. It'll focus mainly on raids and maybe exploring new areas when we first get to them. But we don't know yet. We're just as excited to see what this game brings us as I think everyone else is out there. It's part of why I'm doing this live stream right now, to kind of give a better idea of what the final content may in fact be, and so I have some time to tweak it before the final one comes out. That being said, I wish Greg was here. A little backup for this would be fantastic. Where am I going? Over there. I got bogeys coming. Oh, this game gets more intense after Earth. I was a little worried, in all honesty, that it was going to be a little...
You can grab your Sparrow now. We're linked.
Oh, that's good to know.
The colony base he was looking for should be on the other side of the ridge.
Let's go check out this moon. That's a guy on a speeder bike. Crap. Shit. If I can shoot him off that speeder bike. Okay, so this is actually something I'm hoping is in the final game. As I've alluded to, we're going to do a little more content about the Destiny beta. It won't be part of this whole Destiny Week thing I did. Actually, this is a good way to end Destiny Week with our first live broadcast for the site, or for the channel, I guess. Once I can find the exit to this damn room. I hope you enjoyed Destiny Week, by the way. It's our first theme week, and it was, little more work than it probably had to be because I didn't plan it out so well. Where's that guy on that bike going? I don't know. Let's get the hell out of here. So we have probably only one more video before the actual game comes out, and it's gonna be our first real talking Destiny, discussing Destiny episode. And basically, it's just going to be a wrap-up of what we're hoping is going to be in the game from the beta to the final product. What we liked about this, what we learned about the game, some changes we enjoyed, like the hand cannon being a primary weapon as opposed to a secondary weapon and stuff like that. There's a lot of stuff we were big fans of that they changed. And and in good ways, for the most part. Aha! I got the speeder bike! Yes! These things are such a pain in the ass to fight in multiplayer. Mine is slightly less on fire than his, so I'll stick with mine. Part of me really hopes you can eventually upgrade your Sparrow to having a gun on it. That'd be awesome in my book, like Borderlands assault vehicle style. Get the turret symbol, which had me a little worried. Archer's line. Oh, the thing's almost slagged. But I'll keep it. I have to find one of those goddamn tank things.
This is where he was headed.
That'd be bad. No, I'll keep the discipline still. And sniping time. As you can see, I am not the best sniper in video games. I wish I was. I can get better after I play a couple hours normally if I kind of get in the groove of it, but I actually haven't played too much of this game today in kind of anticipation for this. As I mentioned, my PS4 has been having some issues, and I'm pretty sure they're linked to overheating or something like that. So the goal was to keep the PS4 as happy as possible, as long as possible, so I could actually do this. Didn't seem to be completely successful with the PS4 at least turned back on after I did it, so. Let's see what we got now. Scanning.
They're all about a place called the Temple of Crota. It's not far from here. Sounds like a death trap.
Great! Just great. Temple of Crota. Things that could be not more horrifying sounding if they tried. Ah, fuck it. That was a waste. But I do love punching captains to death, so I'm not sure I should complain. There are more things in there. Ah, just the hover. Alright, let's grab the sparrow. That sounded bad, and we are running. And we're going the wrong way. Oh, not as bad as I thought. I don't know why I keep bringing out the ghost. Please tell me he can't heal. That just pissed me off. Okay, how do I get to this Temple of Crota thing? Maybe murdering some dudes are the answers I seek. Oh, post rifle, you are my favorite weapon in the game. I would love some more primary weapon variety, but they'll have a hard time competing against you. Oh, there, got it. Oh, I wish I could equip you.
The ground here is hollowed out for miles. Who knows what's happening under your feet?
My guess is Hive. My guess is Hive, Peter Dinklebot.
I think we found the temple.
Yup. God damn it, Greg. I wish you were here right now.
Guardian down.
Ah. That's cool. By cool, I mean unfortunate. And what were you? Warlock! I think? Yeah. And cutscene, I think.
There's nothing left. Not even the light. Where is this ghost?
Well, this ain't good. Okay, so the game's now crashed out and crashed my PS4 2-3 times. It's the third attempt at the moon. The moon is coming, if you're just joining us and haven't seen the other stuff. Destiny's doing a special one-day, two-hour event. They've opened some stuff up. Excuse me, and that stuff is the moon. We got about, I'm guessing, two-thirds of the way through the first moon mission, if there is more than one moon mission, and then it crapped out on me. I mentioned earlier I'm grabbing the Titan. I'll be playing a Titan, the final product. Greg will be playing a Hunter. If you want to play a lot of Destiny and want to be on a show like this or something like that, please let me know. Oh, sorry to back way up. This is a form of exploring Destiny, for lack of a better phrase. Our goal is for Exploring Destiny to become a weekly, however long it takes, live show that you can tune into and watch and heckle and all that stuff. And initially, I think the goal is to just, or the plan, not the goal. The goal is going to be to have a third person eventually in the Something Wicked Studios staff, family, collective, join us and play Destiny with us. But it also might be fun to do a random pick of the fan or something like that to have for our third member of the fire team. Who knows? We'll figure it out or something. But anyways, see where this leaves me. I've got part of the way through. See where this leaves me. Oh, not that far behind where I was. Cool. Thank you, checkpoints.
Up ahead, Guardian down.
This will make editing fun. And the ghost is glitching out. There it goes.
There's nothing left.
Not even the light. Where's this ghost?
Oh yeah, she's trouble. She's not wearing a helmet, I don't think. Just a exo mask. Could be wrong, though.
We may want to move back.
Yeah. I'm guessing that's an absolutely thing we want to do.
We've woken the hive!
Oh, dear God! Yay! Hive, my favorite. My one regret is not having. See if a grenade helps send him out. This is nuts. Thank you, Titan Fist, for being what you are. So let's take that down. We're on the move again. Son of a bitch. Only one knight? Cool, that I can handle. Haha! Deep Fist. I see you. You ain't safe. Coming for you. Yeah. And still getting some signs of hostile, so up there. Let's get them. But they jumped down. Reloading. Got any guys left? Nope. Guess it's time to You're stunned. How are you using tactics? Oh boy.
I'm picking up the dying light of a ghost. Inside.
Fuck it. See what I got. Haha! Took down part of it. Oh, come on! How was I to know there was a wizard? Goddamn wizard. I got part of myself. Fuck! Alright, time to lame it out. Heavy weapon ahoy! Oh god, please don't kill me, poison. That'd be bad.
The ghost is dead, but I can still read some of its memories. The Hive are raising an army here, preparing to invade Earth. We need to stop them.
Not sure it's totally new news, really. Pretty sure you could have guessed invading Earth was what they were up to.
Hahaha.